What a pleasant surprise. I wasn't expecting anyone else in today with all the snow. I suppose that you must have been caught up in the midst of it. I can't imagine that anyone safe and warm at home would be willing to venture out into that just for stopping into this little shop. May I ask if you intended to stop by here in particular, or if you just happened to stumble in, as it was the nearest warm building? Just getting out of the snow. I can't blame you for that. Not one bit. You're more than welcome to sit by the fire in here until the outdoors is in a state more to your liking. I could give you a warm drink and a book. Could just leave you alone. Or if you'd like to help pass the time, I could give you a look at the items we have for sale in here. If you have any particular friends in mind that you'd like to fetch some gifts for Yule, I could certainly help you with that. Wonderful. Well, in that case, it would be exceedingly helpful if you could tell me a bit about each of your friends who you'd like to find the perfect gift for. Yes, just any details about personalities or interests that you think might be relevant. Go ahead. Yes. Baking. Whittling. Oh, an innkeeper. Here in Harpington. Would you happen to be referring to Bridget of the Babblebrook Inn? Oh, wonderful. Yes, I'll be able to help you find a great gift for her. And who else? Brooding. Tremendous. Silence. Look who's quite popular. Familiar with many faces around here, it seems. Just to make sure I have all that right, we first have a bright, cheerful innkeeper who enjoys baking and whittling. Then someone brooding and dramatic with an affinity for fine, elegant artifacts. And then someone serene and mysterious. Yes. And then last, someone warm and bumbling who adores beings of every shape and size. Does that sound about right to you? Good. I suppose we should begin with Bridget. I have many ideas. The first of which is that I think that she would quite enjoy some new decorations for her inn. Yes, at Babblebrook they tend to like to go all out in their decor for Yuletide season. I was thinking about perhaps a nice new pillow for that gorgeous chair by the fireplace, just as you walk through the door, you know, the one. Wouldn't this look just lovely perched up on that chair? It's hand embroidered with exactly of these incredibly detailed wreaths, and stuffed full of the softest goose feathers. So very comfortable and plush. And then on the back, a nice shade of red. So this would be my first idea. I think it would look quite fetching. Or perhaps for the little table, the oak one next to that chair. This could look lovely, don't you think? The base is a soft cream linen. And then it features intricate embroidery. A bold red stitch outlines the entirety of the fabric. And then a forest green cross stitch, zigzagging back and forth. Some more little red stitches. And then flip it over. You can see carefully sewn in. Not the colored wool. Or more of the snowflake reminiscent patterns. There's the one, two, and three. And then on the back, a striking buttercup yellow. I also know that at Babblecook, they have a beautiful set of bells hanging at the door that each time someone enters, Bridget will be alerted to their presence, so she knows to assist. For Yuletide, she might like to replace the regular bells with a set of more festive ones. These are glistening golden cowbells, two white and red braided strands. Another possible decoration could be this adorable garland of dwarven socks in all sorts of colors. I apologize that they're in a bit of a tangle, but I hope you can get the idea. Love to create ornaments inspired by the woodland creatures that I often see wandering about the forests just outside of town, such as a little fox, little ears, nice little white-tipped tail, beautiful eyes, incredibly detailed, soft, high-quality ornaments. And everyone fastened with a sturdy leather tie pine cones. Another ornament I think she might take a liking to. It's this. Paint it along the edges with red. Tie it off with a sturdy twine. And in the center, you can see this carefully painted snowflake. And the rest is covered in little I can just picture it on the tree about the brook. It's beautiful every single year, and I think this would make an incredible addition. Those ornaments get passed down from generation to generation. Some are fairly new. Others are hundreds of years old. So it's quite exciting to add a new ornament to the tradition, isn't it? To imagine that many generations from now, your gift will still be proudly hung up on the tree and being admired. Where might I suggest this beautiful burlap heart? And once again, tied off at the top with twine. Or a mother and baby hedgehog. Checkered red scarf. But the ornament that I think would be best of all for Bridget. Pepper is well known throughout all of Harvington. She might spend her evenings and nights at the Babblebrook Inn, but during the day, she likes to venture out and make her rounds, visiting nearly every single shopkeep in all. Each and every Yule, I'm sure, to create plenty of little ornaments of Pepper. Because many of the townspeople love to get their hands on one. So, what do you think? Would Bridget like any of those? You think the ornament? I'd have to agree. So I can set that aside, and then once we're done, we can discuss what sort of wrapping you might like. Sure. So now we can move on to who's next. How about the menagerie owner? Let's see. I think I have a wonderful idea. Perhaps a nice wooden sled, but not just any sled. This sled would be the perfect size for many of our creatures, wouldn't you say? Yes. It isn't just us who like to enjoy gliding through slopes of freshly fallen snow. I think that she might love to take some of her little creatures out for some winter adventures in the forests. Of her creatures who spend time outside of the menagerie, out in the forests, scavenging for food, collecting all the berries and the nuts they'll need for their hibernation, loading up before the winter. I think that this could come in handy instead of just stuffing all of the food they can carry into their hands and their cheeks. They could make use of this sled to carry much more at once and drag it back into the menagerie. So, both for fun and practicality. And if you would like to spruce up that particular gift to be extra special, might I suggest the addition of some jingling bells? String these about onto the sled. I think it would make for an especially beautiful gift. Nothing makes a sleigh ride more special than a gorgeous set of beautifully jingling bells. These are just right, don't you? And they vary in size. Or is there anything else that you think that she might like? Some mittens. Alright, I'll show you what we have. Be these ones. Beautiful, soft, warm red mittens. And they feature a detailed striped and zigzag. Blues and browns. And my most favorite feature of all is the fact that you can keep the tips of your fingers nice and warm when you need to, but when you need to make use of them, this part can fold back and you can use your fingertips if need be. For a menagerie owner, I'm not privy to all of the aspects of creature care, but I can imagine that detail work with the hands could often be necessary. I could also show you some of the other winter items I have in here if you'd like. Well, a nice sleeves down to a pair of tassels knotted off at the end. Generously lined on the inside with wool to keep you perfectly warm. Did any of those catch your eye? The mittens? Perfect. I'll set those aside for you, along with a little pepper. Let's see. What do we have next? Shall we move on to the brooding, dramatic one? Let's see what I have here. Might I suggest an elegant black fur shawl? A stunning midnight black fox fur lined on the inside. You said she has quite refined, elegant tastes. So I thought this might be fitting for her. As a matter of fact, I do, but only dried persimmons. Would that be all right? Well, have them in a little pouch like this. I can show you one if you like. Sliced and dried like this. They smell delicious. Be sure of what you're buying before you purchase it, don't you? The shawl and the pouch of persimmons. Perfect. Set those aside for you. And who's left? Oh, just one more. The serene, mysterious one with a soft spot for sweet. Well, as far as sweets, one of our most popular varieties are our gingerbread houses. Do you think she might fancy one of those? I don't know anyone who wouldn't. We have three different types available. As for her interest in blossoms and herbs, might I suggest a wreath of pine cones, figs, cranberries, and various rare and delightfully scented herbs. All fastened upon a tightly woven bed. You've selected each of the gifts that you would like. We can discuss how you would like for each of them to be wrapped. This is the set of wrapping paper that I use here in the shop. All lovingly hand-painted with intricate festive designs. The first is in that striking buttercup yellow and spotted with like a more intricate, complex design. We have a brick red painted with yellow plant-like designs and green suns. Something perfectly simplistic. First option is a twisted red and beige twine. Or light green. A cream and red stripe, much like peppermint. Emily, may I ask if you'd like me to give you all of your gifts now and you can deliver them to each of the recipients yourself? Or if for only two curlings extra per package, if you would like us to hand deliver your gifts for you? So, you would like the Babblebrook and Menagerie gifts delivered, but you would like the others, you would like to deliver those yourself? No problem at all. So, the Babblebrook Inn, I of course know just where that is, but then where exactly is the Menagerie? Would you mind? Perfect. Thank you. So, your total for the delivery of those two packages and the mittens, the thank you very much. I'm so very glad that you happened upon my shop this evening. You're more than welcome to have a seat by the fire or over by the window, wherever you like, until, as I said, you're more comfortable with the weather. In the meantime, I'll just be tending to things about the shop, and let me know if you need anything. All right? Wonderful. Oh, and also, thank you.